at the end of the meal, having the dessert could be the most memorable. It doesn't have to be too complicated, but eating it probably will like remind you of some kind of flavors that you had before, like your childhood times or something very familiar to you. This dessert is actually like a donut and a combination of what we have in Singapore, the ham ji bing. In Taiwan, we call it sambal tai. This idea comes from a corn snack, and we call it a yu mi bang. In Taiwan, there's like a lot of childhood kind of memory from this corn snack.
他在设计这个texture上面，他应该要先怎么样把它分出来，然后我们再来去想我们要做什么样的味道。他会来看，我每一季的菜单或是每张菜单的前面我放了些什么，然后他去做，他最后面把尾巴把它收进来。他的风格，那他是一个新加坡的华人，但他却做有一点台湾味道的甜点。
对，譬如说材料啊，然后一些小小的东西上面是，你可能会会心一笑。There's actually a lot of common things in Singapore and the culture in Taiwan. One of our signature dessert, which is Taiwan's pineapple cake, which is 凤梨酥. But I added more spice into the marmalade because back in Singapore, when we do the pineapple tart, we actually add in a little bit more spices to elevate the flavor. My mom's hobby, it was baking and cooking. And so when I was about 3, I liked to hang around in the kitchen with her. But it started off more like a chaos until I grew up like maybe like 7. That was when I started off really helping her, like, you know, weighing all the stuff, baking with her, cooking with her. We enjoy a lot being together in the kitchen. Chefs isn't that glamorized back then when I make this career switch. But to me, that was what I wanted to be. I'm more comfortable in the kitchen doing baking and plating, that kind of rush feeling. When I told my mom that I want to make the switch, she was totally supportive. She was like, "You should have told me earlier." I joked around and I was like, "Ah, why didn't you hire me?" He kept it in mind and he was setting up Taihua. He called me and asked if I would like to join him in Taiwan as his pastry chef. I took up the offer and right now I'm in Taiwan, Taipei.
Angela 平常跟我最喜欢去做的事情就是到处去吃甜点，以及这些传统的台湾的小吃。
偶尔我们会一起排休，然后就是到台湾各地去旅行跟冒险。Angela 私底下是个非常热情、活泼，而且非常跟我一样就非常人来疯的人，然后就也很贴心，然后对朋友就非常的好。但是在他专业的部分上面，他是一个非常追求完美的人，就是一点点小出错都没有办法接受。台湾的甜点界，我觉得因为在 Angela 就是带入了这些新的元素之后，把这些传统的街边的小吃要上另外一个国际的层次。因为我觉得这边就是非常，就是具有台湾传统小吃的这些精神。
Samoa chip, it's eaten hot and cold because they have like milk flavored ice shavings, and then you have hot mochi with sesame powder or peanut powder and a little bit of sugar. There's like different textures, different flavors, and of course you have like, you know, the hot and cold combination, which is very interesting for me. It's actually something that, you know, you could make into a dessert. This year will be my sixth year. I get to experience earthquakes, typhoon, and you get a call the next day, you know, the farmer telling you, I'm sorry, you're not gonna get your fix because it's blown away. Yeah, so it's something that you have to deal with. It's pretty challenging for me. As a person, Taiwan changed me quite a lot. I get to use a lot of local produce. I get to know more about learning the culture, not only as a chef, also as myself. And interpreting some of this culture into our dessert, which is, for me, a learning experience. The first thing that I want to do is to go back home, of course, give my mom a big hug, go out and have some hawker food. There's a lot of like friends and relatives that I miss hanging out around with back in Singapore, and I miss the food.